Before starting that,
Yes, sir.
can you just tell me? I didn't watch that video again, but when I tried in my office, now you can we can say that a slash, then it will activate all the things. Alt, either one we can use, slash or Alt.
Yes.
Activate the home and.
Yes, 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 yes. Slash also.
Then I want to go to the number. How to go there in the.
At which number?
This number screen is there, no? If you see this, I can show that.
You can show me. I'll make you presentator. Then you can show me.
Yeah.
Yes. Now I can see your screen. Just you have some control like show your screen. You can do that. Yes. Yes, now I can see your screen.
Yeah, go to meeting. But Excel I am not able to see. Okay.
Yeah, I can so see your
Excel?
Yes, yes, yes.
Suppose say, then I want to come here, open this part.
Okay, number what formatting.
Yeah, how number. What is the command for this?
Control then 1. Press control. First you have to press escape for escaping these. Yes. Now press control plus 1. Control and numerical 1.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, but how do we know that this is one? This is what is this one then? Alignment.
These are all same because we are seeing here number tab alignment, and as well it is
yeah,
there also.
How do we, what? Yeah. How do we know that maybe 2 means it will open something? No.
Actually, it is one tab only. And in that you have different tabs in between them, so it will appear from alignment also, number also, and I think from font also it will appear, if I'm right.
Yeah. So now how to do this one? So suppose I want to open this tab, control 1.
Yes, control 1.
Yeah, we cannot see like this kind of things like F, H, N, P, like that. We cannot see something.
No. But that you can't do that.
Okay. Suppose I want to open the alignment.
It is also in control 1. Your font, alignment, and number are in control 1. No, not there.
Okay, I understood. No, yeah, control.
Okay.
Then so we can take the control.
I'll make myself presentator.
Yeah.
Now, let's start with custom formatting. So, suppose we were entering some check numbers there,
but I'm not able to see. One second,
you can see my screen or not?
This is your screen. Oh, this is my screen. No, I am not able to. Yeah. Now I can see.
So I'm entering this check number. And accidentally, if it is gone, convert to numbers, then press just control 1, go to number tab, go to custom, and enter 6 times 0 for 6 digits. It means it will show you the values in 6 digit, and if you have entered only one digit, it will fix 000 before your value up to 6 digit. So this is for showing purpose only, it is not actual. You can do calculations over there. Basically, when you apply custom formatting, the zero is a placeholder for your digit. Now, if you want to type mobile number here, and you want to apply +91 before that, before every number, just go to control 1 in custom, and you have to type +91, and then you can put hyphen or space and 10 times 0. Now you apply any number and +91 will be fixed here. But what happens if I enter less digits, less than 10 digits? It will fill rest of the digits with zero. So now it is wrong. Somewhere the purpose is destroyed here. So how we will do that? You just select all of them, and instead of putting zero, you can apply a hash. So it will not fill anything. Hash is a placeholder for numbers, that how many numbers you want to put, the actual value will be there only, and whatever you want to fix, fix before that. Okay, you can usually write these things, number.
What it means, that hash means it is just the number, whatever the number of digits we can do that.
It is just only the number. We can control number by two way, with hash or with zero. Zero makes the compulsion for entering digits. If it is not there, it will fill with zeros. But in case of hash, it is not there. It will show you the simple number you have entered.
Okay. If it is more than the, like, you know, the restricted, maybe 10 digits, maybe if I enter 20 digits, it will take it, or it will cut down the only first 10 digits.
If you let me complete first with a telephone number. Now I want to apply here country code and phone number. So country code will be +91-0129, state code, district code actually, and then I will press hash. Now if I enter any landline number, it will be fixed before that. But what's happening there? The 129 is somewhere else, and something is wrong there, because number is disturbing here. So we enter usually for 10 to 15 times, or whatever we want, how many digits we want there, we put as a hash. So it will show your prefix numbers with your actual number. And it is a format. Your format painter can paint that format here. Okay. What's happening here? If I don't give this much of digit, it will start adjusting in that one. In hash, it will take only one digit, last digit, and rest of that after it is adjusting here automatically. So we don't want our value to be fixed here and there. If we want to stick our values to these directions, we must put some hashes to the extent of how we want our values. The digits should be pasted here, but if I paste with 0, it will fill with 0. This is the basic difference between that. Now, let's take another example sheet. Another one is this telephone number, like, and such as our meeting ID. Basically it is 9 digits, and what format we will apply for that. We'll put #, dash, #, dash, #, means after 3 digit it will put hash in that, dash in that. So I will type 987768. It will be distributed, but when I put more than 9 digit, it will adjust rest of the value in front of the format. Okay, because 3 digits are segregated here, 3 is here, and the rest of all here. It behaves like that. Such as we are putting the value such as account number, it is 6, maybe 16 digits or whatever the number. When you enter this number, when you press enter, it converts to an exponential number. If you want to show your figure fully, then you need to go to custom and put 0 or hash here. For pasting numbers just like that. The actual value is exponential, but when we put 0 or hash, it will show all the digits here. So these are some small things which you can see here. Now let's work with date format. we apply date like this. You go to custom. For understanding these, let's press F1 from your Excel screen, go to help and type custom format. Create or delete a custom number format. You'll find these are the signs which you can enter directly. Plus sign, parenthesis, colon, you can fix directly. Then zero, this is the digit placeholder displays insignificant zero if a number has fewer digits. The digit placeholder hash, the same rules as zero, however Excel does not display extra zeros. This is the basic difference between zero and hash. And such as zero and hash, there is one more placeholder, that is question mark. Works as zero, however Excel adds a space for insignificant zeros. Align, it is basically used for aligning the decimals. If you put some values like that 8.9, 4.56 and 5.564, when I select that and put question mark over there, question mark, it will make space for that digit. And I inserted a dot and again question mark. Your decimals will be aligned there. The dots will be in same alignment. It will maintain the space of 3 digits here. Suppose I can exceed for 4 digit and here I enter 3 digit. So it will show you that how to align these things, such as 1 to 4, 8.9, I can put 2 more digits here. There is a space for that. Basically, it is used for spacing only. Okay, there are a lot of codes to display this one as this. You may apply this code. And 8.9 as 8.900, you may apply this code. There is 0 pasted here, it means 0 will be filled after 9 if there is a no digit. After period it will complete 3 digit. In that case, I am entering here 0.631 and the format is 0. hash. Whether there is a value or not before dot, it will paste a 0 there, and after then how many digits you put, it will show you here. hash point zero hash. Means it will definitely show you point zero, but after that, if the digit come, it will show you, but not filled with zero. If there is no, it will put zero. If there is digit, it will maintain the digits of two. Now, as question mark, I have shown you for aligning decimal. And 5.25. When we want to show as a fractional number, we can use this code. Hash for digit with a space. You need to put a paste a space here, otherwise it will not show you the correct value. And then you can paste this question mark with bracket sign with slash slash will convert automatically this to fractional number. Now there are a lot of more. 12,000 to display as with comma separator. You have this code hash comma three time hash. The three digit would be passed here and then a comma and then 12.
There are some cases like in some formats when we download the data, for example, especially European kind of thing, like 12,000 or 12,000 rupees 55 pills. What will happen is 12,000 comma 55 paise.
Okay.
It will come like that in some cases. How to convert it to 12,000.59?
12,000?
12,000 comma? Dot comma.
Comma?
Just comma?
Yes.
59.
5? 9. 9.
It means like 12,000 rupees 59 paise.
So you want to show this value.
One way is that I am replacing with the comma as a point, a dot.
So it will show you, you will create code with this one. You will put hash hash. I can put separator here. Hash hash hash. Dot or comma hash hash. No, it should be done with that. Yes.
The easy way, I'm just doing that replace. Find comma, replace with the dot.
I'm just not replacing that. It is like that you want.
No, I don't want like this. I am getting the data as 1000 comma.
Okay. You are getting the data as, one second, like this. So you are replacing them.
Yeah.
We find and replace comma with dot.
Yeah. So with the dot. Yeah. That way I'm just managing the thing.
Yes, that is also good. But if you want to show as 12,000 rupees and 59 paise, you will do, go to custom format. When you have type text here, then you will type text in inverted commas, rupees. I'm showing a space here. It has converted in Chinese. what I'm doing is rupees space hash dot hash hash paise. Okay, or I can put here like and I'll put one dot here, or I can break, I think this one, no, not this one. Yes, I need to specify dot here. See, but in that you can calculate also. If you apply this form there, you want to add 10 rupees in that, you can add that. So whenever you want to type text here, you just put in inverted commas. Okay.
One more point in this.
Yes.
Sometimes the data is compared as negative figures.
Yes.
As 12,000. After that, it will come as a minus.
Okay.
When we download some database from some system.
So you do with find replace. That is also correct.
Yeah, I what? No, the find replace will not work. What I have to do is that minus figures I have to put in front, then it will be a minus figure.
Oh, you get point.
Yeah, you type that 12,000, then minus, yes, enter.
Yes.
Other item is 10,000.
10,000. Okay, 10,000.
Or whatever it is. Yeah.
It is like
so,
plus.
Okay, then. No. Plus won't be there. If it is a positive figure, there won't be any plus. Okay, enter.
Mm.
So now I have to replace this minus. I have to minus, bring it to the front side. Left side.
If there is a minus, you want to.
Basically, there is a minus figure. But it, when we are downloading the database, it, normally I am using if function in the next column and convert it.
Find that minus first within this text, and if it is there,
no, what I used to do is if
you what you fix there,
if the logic is contains
contains is like that. Contains, you have function like that, contains. No, you just go through the filter. You go to the filter, I think. You go to the filter like that. If there is you text filter and contains minus like this.
Yeah.
You find.
So then I will replace with wherever that is there, then I have to bring that minus in print. That's it.
Okay. So if I have to done with formula, I will just find this one in the text. If there is no error, I will substitute that. If is error, if the error is there, it will do nothing. But if it is not there, we will do substitute minus, and
now you have to
the text, old text, new text, text, old text, new text will be nothing, and in new text I will concatenate this one. In my if condition, value if true it is blank, value if false, substitute all text to blank. Why it is not doing all the thing? Evaluated.
I believe it. I know how to handle this one, but I'm just handling by just filtering that and then copy he there to the next, and like that I used to do that.
Old text, new text, and instant. It is like that. It is like that.
Okay.
I create. Yes, I have created a formula here for doing all the things. Okay, so I will let you know about these formulas, how to apply these formulas in our formula training. Let's understand the conditional, this custom format. And you can put the colors also in custom formatting, such as there is something value, if you want to show as red, you can show some colors over here in between these big brackets. The only these colors you can use with that. You can specify condition in between that, such as if the value is less than equal to 100, it will show you red. If the value is greater than 100, it will show you blue. So you can specify conditions in between, separated with semicolon. Such as I apply here. Works as conditional formatting.
Normally we are using the other conditional formatting tab.
Yes, conditional formatting, but it can be done through that. But sometimes it is of no use, but we must know that what is the functionality of this custom format. So I will put red if the value is greater than equal to 100, separated with semicolon. It would be blue if the value is greater than 100. Just like that. If there is greater value, it will convert in blue. So you can apply conditional formatting here with the help of these codes. And let's see the dates, how the date format works. As you know, if we enter a date, such as we have entered date here. Now in date section there are a lot of date formats here. You can create your own, such as we can use, if we want to show month only here, we will use M. It will show you month. We can use double M for showing value. If it is 1, 2, 3 in single digit, it will show you in double digit, prefixed with 0. If you put 3 times M, it will show you the month name as January, abbreviated month name. If you put 4 times, it will show you full name. The actual value is date only, but you can choose your own format. If you put 5 times M, it will show you initial of the month, initial digit, such as J. So I want to put here month name, and now after comma I want to show date. If I put D, it will show you, show the value in single digit. If I put double D, it will show me in double digit. And if I put 3 times D, it will show me the day name, Wednesday, Thursday, abbreviated day name. If I put 4 times D, it will show me the full day name, Sunday, Monday, Wednesday. In sample box you can see. So we can use that up to 4 digit. Here I will put like that. Now I put space and the year. Year we enter in 2 digit or 4 digit. Okay, now I want to show day name before that. So I will put DDDD and put a long space there. So how you want to show your date, it is up to you. If the format is not there, you can create by yourself. Let's see the example of that. If you show the month like this, you will use this code in 2 digits, double M, 3 times M for abbreviated month name, and such as the examples I have told you. Okay. All for dates. Now let me talk about R and month time. I put here current time. So basically it is in 12 hours format. You can see the format for that. If you put H, it will show you the hours, such as 22, full hours. If you want to show in AM PM, just AM slash PM, it will show you in this format. AM PM you can use A and P, A slash P, so it will show you single. H and semicolon, a colon, and M for minute. Here M will be used as minute. Now you can also put AM PM like this. If you want to show the seconds, you can put like that. S. Now, if I need to display the time in 24-hour format, I will remove this AM/PM. It will show me in 24-hour format. But if there is we talk about time elapsed, then we put bigger brackets here. Now what I'll do, I copy this format here and just add one day in it. It will show me like that, in elapsed format, in bigger brackets. Such as if you want to show elapsed minute, you can put bigger brackets here also in minutes. Minutes and seconds. And if you want to show elapsed seconds, you can show here. The AM/PM you can use with these codes. So there are a lot of codes. You want to display R like that, you can put H in double digits, double H. Minutes in single digit, M. Double digit, double M. Second, as well as AM, PM, like this, and all the things. Elapse hours, H in brigade brackets, elapse minutes, M in brigade brackets, elapse time, seconds, S in brigade brackets. Now if I want to know the elapsed minute, I will do this format. If I want to know the elapsed second, I'll do like this. So the conversion of time is in your hand now. These are all the examples of this custom number format. Just practice it once with that. Here it, one more thing I show you, that working with text, it is all about numbers and date. Now how to handle text? Suppose sometime we create format and we put like this name and space for name, I put underscore as underline. But when I'm going to remove my columns and reduce my columns, it will be disturbed, as I want that the enhancement of this sign should be with the column height, column width. So what I'll do that, I'll press Control 1, go to custom, and for text, if you want to show this text with something, we will put at the rate, and after that star and the sign I want to enhance. Whatever you put after star will be repeated to the column width. If I exceed the column, it will be exceeded. Whatever I put with star, such as I put S, it will be repeated by the times if there is a space in column width. So how we use these. So star with text, it has limited use. So these things are done with custom formats. And you can search formats for Indian number format, like I have a code here. I have searched through net. If you search, you will find that Indian number format. Here it is, ₹12,334, 1,23,415. If you see the number formatting, it is like that. It is this code is used there, in which there are conditions, and the code which will to be applied here, separated with semicolon, the conditions again. If the value is greater than this number, this code will be applied. If the value is greater than this number, this code will be applied. And the rest of all values, this code will be applied. So you can modify as you want. You can search it on net. Now, I have told you about it is for just for visibility, but when we want actual values, such as that check numbers, I want to not printing purpose, but actually I want to be my values like that. So I will use text formula. In text formula, one reference for the values, and in another one you will put your format, whatever custom format you want to put, you can put in that. 6×0 I put in that, and now drag it. Now if you copy and paste as values these things, so it will return in real values. You can see here. Okay, for date, if you want something format to be like that, so you can choose through text. Okay. So it will be the actual value. It will be the actual value. In your text for text formula, you can do all the things. So for today, I think it is enough to have intro with custom formatting. Okay, sir. So let's try the different formats as practice and read it once. Whatever I have shown to you, just type custom format and go with that. Okay, sir. Read it once, apply to that, because it takes time for mastering these things. Okay, do try this one also, because this will useful to create millions into lakh into million into we can say we say value in crore, value in lakh. Yes, so it will show you like this, and this format will show you the only value like this. in digits. So practice with that. We will meet in our next session tomorrow with something sorting and filter or maybe new thing. Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, good night.